You know it's a good product when you've used it to the very last drop. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel where we talk about all things Asian beauty, skincare, and lifestyle. And today I am quite literally dumping out all of these products to share with you guys my Asian beauty, skincare, and hair care empties for the last few months. I've literally collected trash. Gold trash, but trash for the last few months to do this video for you guys. So make sure to go ahead and like this video and let's get right on into it. Kicking off the skincare category, I had to start with my favorite Japanese skincare line of the moment, Hadarabo. This is the Hadarabo Gokujin Hyaluronic Acid Light Toner. This is honestly an amazing lightweight toner for those of you guys looking for something lighter. If you have oily combination skin type, this is the toner for you. Now you might be wondering, hey, like, don't you have dry skin? So why would you recommend this? Honestly, this is actually perfect for dry skin types in the summertime or in early fall. So I still recommend it for dry skin types as well as oily skin types, but it's a definite repurchase for me on this one. Up next, if you've been watching any of my skincare videos, this product always pops back up because I use it so much and repurchase it several times, and I've been using it probably for the last 3 or 4 years. This is the Laneige Essential Power Skin Toner for normal to dry skin. I love the gel-like consistency and it keeps my skin moisturized throughout the day, and I actually use it with all different seasons, but I highly recommend it, especially during the spring and fall time, because it's super moisturizing, but it's not as heavy as some of the other toners I use. The next empty that I have here is the Plant-Based Time Stop Collagen Ampoule. I absolutely love this one, and I've turned actually several of my friends and even my mom onto this product. This is an amazing ampoule that is super nourishing and helps with your skin's radiancy. It comes once again in a thicker gel consistency, but I find that even if it is a thicker gel consistency, it really does absorb into your skin super well and helps prep the skin for other products later on. Highly recommend this for anyone with a sensitive skin type, whether it's oily or dry. And here's another empty from the Plant-Based. This is their Petal Essence. And first and foremost, the one thing that I absolutely love about this is how easy it is to use. You can use it while doing your skincare, or you can use it after you've already applied your makeup just to create some nourishment and moisture in your skin throughout the day. It is absolutely amazing at energizing and toning out your skin and just keeping it super moisturized throughout the day. I highly recommend it for all skin types, and it's something that I actually keep in my purse because it's super easy to use and helps with skin hydration all throughout the day. The next empty I have is the Innisfree Green Tea Cleansing Oil. Now, Innisfree is one of my favorite Korean skincare lines just because of how affordable and effective this entire brand is. They do have several different lines that you can choose from depending on what you're trying to achieve with your skin or what your skin type is. This Green Tea Cleansing Oil is actually one of my favorite lines that they have. This cleansing oil is super lightweight while still being an oil that removes your makeup, and it removes even waterproof makeup. So I highly recommend this one. And last but not least in the skincare category, this is the Haruharu Wonder Black Rice Hyaluronic Anti-Wrinkle Serum. I've actually featured this in several of my skincare videos before, and I absolutely love this. First off, because of how well it balanced out my skin tone, it nourished, moisturized, and everything in between. And it also, on top of that, smells like lavender and eucalyptus. It literally feels like you are having a spa treatment every time you use it. So I highly recommend checking out Haruharu's line of skincare. Super clean, easy to use, and it literally feels like you're in a spa every single time. So to start off the makeup category, I had to start off with a cushion foundation empty, because just by looking at my YouTube channel, you could probably tell in first glance that I love cushion foundations, and I've done several different video series just on cushion foundations, and this one is absolutely one of my favorites. I repurchase it every single time I run out of it. This is the Troy Adake Cushion Age Plus. Troy Adake is actually a skincare company that started to dabble in makeup, came up with this cushion foundation, and they are genius for doing it. It's super lightweight, creates a dewy look. It also has sunscreen. Once again, it's skincare based, and it It's just so good. I highly recommend it for everyone, no matter what your skin type is. It's something that fits in with a lot of people's skin type, and it's great. No other words. It's great. Now this next product, I feel like I featured way too much in all of my makeup videos in 2020, but this is the Pony Effect Strobing Luminizer. I used it so much so that the pony effect has completely worn off. You can't even see that. But it's absolutely stunning on the skin. It's not oily, but it gives you this beautiful shimmer to your skin. And if you layer foundation over it, it just looks like your skin is glowing from within. Once again, it doesn't feel oily at all. It doesn't feel tacky on the skin. It just gives it a nice luminous, pearly look to your skin. Now I really, really, really do love cushion foundations, but I really wanted to try a CC cream out, and this one did not disappoint. This is the Mother's Made Aqua Light CC Cream with SPF 50 Plus and PA Triple Plus. It's a 3-in-1 complete care cream for youthful and smooth, silky skin. I absolutely love this just because of how lightweight it was. It almost felt like a tinted moisturizer, and it was super easy to blend. I didn't have to use a puff afterwards to blend it in, and it almost had kind of a watery cream texture, if that makes any sense. It was absolutely amazing. Once again, an affordable CC cream. A lot of CC creams run very, very expensive, so if you are looking for a CC cream, I highly recommend trying this one out. And last but not least in the makeup category, this is the Deja Vu Mascara. This is the Keep Style version, and they do have several different versions depending on what you're looking for, but this is honestly an amazing mascara. It literally lengthens your lashes and keeps them curled all day long. It's a jet black formula, and also the wand is super easy to use because it's curved and bristly, and I absolutely love this. My mom actually uses this as well, so I highly recommend it. It's won several different awards, and if you're looking for a good mascara in Japan, definitely go ahead and try this one out. Now for hair care, I actually only have one empty product. I've talked about this in a video in the past, but I do have problems with thin hair and hair loss, and so a lot of products do weigh down my hair, and if I use too much, it also weighs down my hair. But this is one of my absolute Japanese hair care favorites. This is the Fiance Hair Mist, and first off, it smells absolutely amazing. It has this almost soapy, clean scent with a touch of floral, so it's super clean but girly. It's something that you could just spray in your hair. It keeps it super shiny, and if you walk by someone, your hair smells absolutely amazing, and it almost seems like you're wearing a perfume. So definitely try this one out. So that's gonna be it for this week's video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it, and as always, I'll leave all the links to all the products that I mentioned in this week's video in the description down there for you guys to go ahead and check out and hopefully pick up one of your own that's not empty. But I'm gonna go ahead and end this video here. Thank you guys so much for all the love and support here on YouTube as well as my Instagram. If you haven't started following me on there, I've started to dabble in a few different styles of content on my Instagram, so I'd love for you guys to join there. And if you haven't joined here on YouTube, I'd love for you guys to go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I upload every single Saturday about Asian beauty, skincare, and lifestyle, and I will see you guys next week. Bye, everyone.